Hi, hello, good morning to all my dear students. Welcome back to our online classes. Today's class is for third standard. What we have discussed in previous class? We have discussed about second lesson, that was the Emperor's New Clothes. So what were the main characters? Narrator, Emperor, two weavers, ministers, officers, people in the streets, and the child, the father of that child. So what was the lesson about? The lesson was about an emperor. Raja irthane, he was always giving priority to his clothes. Janagal bage yojane madbeke hortu, what he was doing yavaglu tan battegalde chinte avange. ಸೊ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಪಾಠ ಕಲಿಸ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಇಬ್ರು ಬರ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದೇ ವೇರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ದ ವೇವರ್ಸ್, ದೇ ವೇರ್ ಪ್ರಿಟೆಂಡೆಡ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ವೇವರ್ಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅವರು ಬಂದು ನಾ ಬಟ್ಟೆ ಹೊಲಿಯೋದು ಯಾರಿಗೂ ಕಾಣಿಸಂಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಕಾಣಿಸೋದು ಓನ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ಇಂಟೆಲಿಜೆಂಟ್ ಪೀಪಲ್. ಅವಾಗ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ ರಾಜಾ, ವಾಸ್ ಫುಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸೈಟೆಡ್, ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಎಕ್ಸೈಟೆಡ್ ಟು ನೋ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ಸ್ ಫಿಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದೇರ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್. ಯಾರು ಇಂಟೆಲಿಜೆಂಟ್ ಇರೋ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಾ ಅಂದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಬಟ್ಟೆ ಕಾಣೋದಿಲ್ವೋ they are stupids or fools, right? So he decided to call them, and those two people have to work for him. So he called them and they will give some amount of money. ಹೇಳ್ತಾನೆ ಇವಾಗಲೇ ನನಗೋಸ್ಕರ ನೀವು ವರ್ಕ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ವೇವ್ ದ ಕ್ಲಾತ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೀ ರೈಟ್ ನೌ. ಸೊ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ ರೂಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮಷಿನ್ ಗಳು ನೋಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಅದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಬಟ್ಟೆ ಇರಂಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಥ್ರೆಡ್ ಇರಲ್ಲ, ಏನು ಇರಲ್ಲ. ದಿಲ್ ಪ್ರಿಟೆಂಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ವೆರಿ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಡೇ ಅಂಡ್ ನೈಟ್. So one fine day they will finish the weaving. They were pretending aur holita irbekare en madida raja, he will send one of his old clever minister to see how they are weaving the cloths. But when the minister goes into that room, he doesn't say anything. Even though he doesn't say anything, eno helala avanu, why he won't say anything, helidre avanu murkha eno anta ankuntare. So he won't say anything. ಹಿಂಗೆ ಇರ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ದ ಫೈನಲಿ ದ ಕ್ಲಾತ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ರೆಡಿ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್ ಟು ಎಂಪರರ್. ಎಂಪರರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಪ್ರಿಟೆಂಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ವಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಕ್ಲಾತ್, ಬಟ್ ಈವನ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ನಾಟ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್. ಹಾಕೊಂತಾನೆ, ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾನೆ. ಹಿಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಸೇ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ವಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಅ ನ್ಯೂ ಕ್ಲಾತ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ಶೋ ಟು ಆಲ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ. ಸೊ ಹೋಗ್ತಾನೆ, ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾನೆ, ಜನರಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಂತಾರೆ, ಜನರಿಗೂ ಹೇಳೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಮೂರ್ಖರು ಅಂದ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಅವ್ರು ಕಾಣಿಸಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ. ಸೊ ಓ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ವರ್ ಪ್ರೆಡಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದ ಎಂಪರರ್ ಕ್ಲಾತ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಗಾರ್ಜಿಯಸ್, ದ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ಕಲರ್, ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ದೇ ವರ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್. ಅಟ್ ದ ಮಿಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಒನ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ವಾಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್, ಶಿ ಸೇಸ್ ದಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಕ್ಲಾತ್ ಎಟ್ ಆಲ್. ಸೊ ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ವಿಲ್ ವಿಸ್ಪರ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಥಿಂಗ್. ಅಟ್ ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ದ ಕಿಂಗ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ನೋ ದಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಟ್ರೂತ್. ಸೊ ಹಿ ವಿಲ್ ಫೀಲ್ ವೆರಿ ಶೇಮ್ ಆನ್ ದೇರ್. ಏನು ಇವಾಗ ಈ ಥರ ಅರ್ಥ ಏನು ಏನು ಕಳ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಪಾಠದ ಅರ್ಥ ಏನು ಅಂದರೆ, ನಮ್ದು ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ ಕೆಲಸ, ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೂ ದಟ್. ಹಿ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಎಂಪರರ್, ಹಿ ಶುಡ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಓವರ್ ದ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಪೀಪಲ್, ಬಟ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್. ಟು ಟೀಚ್ ಅ ಲೆಸನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಎಂಪರರ್, ಟೂ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಕೇಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಡಿಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ದ ಲೆಸನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಎಂಪರರ್ಸ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಕ್ಲಾತ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ discuss some grammar points of this lesson. Okay, I have told you that in previous class only, in this lesson we are going to study about simple past tense, right? Simple past tense of regular verbs. Simple past tense of regular verbs. Tell me first, what do you mean by past? It's nothing but the things or any actions which has already happened in the past, which has already happened. So we will see what it is. So when we will use this simple past tense? We use simple past tense to talk about actions that are finished in the past. See, what do you mean by past tense? I have told you that the things which we will the action which are already happened, that is called as past. So when we will use the simple past tense, we use simple past tense to talk about the actions that finished in the past, which has already finished. For such things we will say past tense. Verbs which form the simple past form by adding ed at the end of the base verbs are called as regular verbs. Verbs which form their simple past form by adding ed at the end of the base regular verbs. See here, what they are telling here? Verbs which form their simple past form by adding ed at the end of the base verb. If we add ed at the end of the base verb, such words are called as regular verbs. Understand? So when we will use this simple past tense? We use simple past tense to talk about actions that finished in the past. And what do you mean by irregular verbs? Verbs which form their simple past form by adding ed at the end of the base verb. So for base verb, if we add ed, that will become regular verbs. Say for example, dance, look, brush, start. See, observe these words. These are all base verbs. What it is? It is base verb. Understand? For this, we have to add ed. For this, we have to add
so that it will become past tense form.
So together what it will give? Dance is base verb, right? Dance is base verb. For this we are adding ed. Same. Look is a base word. For that we are adding ed. Brush is your base word. We are adding ed. And I'm sorry. This is p. Start is a base word. For that we are adding ed. Okay. So what it will become? Danced.
Looked. Brush plus ed. Brush. Start plus ed. Started.
Can you observe this? Dance, look, brush, start. For all these words we have added ed, right? We have added ed so that it will give you past tense form. Danced, looked, brushed and started. Understand? If we add ed for the base verb so that it will become past tense form. Understand? So let me give you some exercises. This how you learn in words. Now let me tell you how to make sentence in past tense form.
You know what is subject, object and verb, right? Subject plus past tense form of verb and then object. See children, keep it in your mind that always in a sentence there will be subject, verb, object. Okay. See here, subject is here, verb and object. Understand? So this is a format to make a sentence in simple past tense. Subject, past tense form of verb. Nothing but add ed to the base verb. Past tense form of verb is nothing but add ed to the base verb and object. Say for example, we went for a walk last morning. You ate dosas for breakfast yesterday. He watched a movie last night. They went on a family picnic last we. See, what is the formula for it? Subject plus past tense form of verb and object. It is nothing but we have to add ed for base form, right? Can you see examples here? We went for a walk last morning. This is subject, right? Walk is verb and object is last morning. Past tense form is nothing but here it is,
went,
right? And you ate dosas for breakfast yesterday. Subject, past tense form of verb, and dosa is your object. He watched a movie last night. Subject, past tense form of verb. You know, this is past tense form because we have added ed here. A movie last night. They went on a family picnic last week. Subject, this is past tense form of verb. Family picnic, object. Understand? This is what? The concept of what? Simple past tense. Simple past tense. Past means nothing. The things or the action or something which has already happened. We will talk about it's already finished. For such words or things, we say past tense form. Understand now? So let me give you some work. See, I'll put some drawing here. See here, this is a flower. For the flowers, we have some petals. On every each and every petal, I have written some words. For this, you have to add ed and you have to make a verb.
Thank you.
See here. Add ed to the words on the petals to form the past tense form of the verbs. Write the words formed in the space given. So you have to add ed to the words. You have to add ed to the words which are all there in the petals. Look, laugh, call, play, wash, finish, reach, happen, and listen. For these words, you have to add ed. Understand? For these words, you have to add ed. So this is a more simple past tense. And next is let me tell you something. Look at what the people in the play say about the emperor's clothes. When you say nice words about someone's clothes, we say that you compliment the person. I have told you before only, in this lesson we are going to learn about how to give compliments. See, if someone, let me take example of emperor only, he was wearing a new coat, right? Actually he was not wearing, he was wearing a new coat. For that, what happened? Everyone are telling the cloth is very nice. The colors are gorgeous, right? So, we say that you compliment the person. If you say nice words about someone's clothes, anything, that may be anything, right? If you say nice words, then it is compliment. Oh, it is beautiful. The colors are gorgeous and the pattern is very fine. Look at these words. You can use them when you compliment a friend. If you are giving a compliment to your friend or anyone, you can use that words. I like your shirt. Where did you get it? Your jacket really suits you. The color is nice. I love your scarf. It matches your dress. See, these are all giving the compliments. Always accept a compliment politely with the words like thank you. Understand? Compliment is nothing but saying good words. Okay. Compliment is nothing but saying good words. This is about compliment. So this is about the grammar part of this lesson. Write your compliment in the space. See, in page number 32, you have this exercise. Can you see it? This is, look at the each picture and think of a compliment you may pay the person. Write your compliment in the space given. This is your homework. You have to write a compliment by seeing the picture. They have given you sunset. Example, your friend is wearing a new cap. Hello, Amit. Your new cap suits you very well. First, they have given you example. See here, they only gave. For this, you have to make yourself. And one more thing, writing part is there. The little child in the play said that emperor had no clothes on. Read the lines again. Narrator, no one wanted to say that they could not see anything. They were afraid that people would think they were stupid. Little child. But he has nothing on. Little child's father. So we have already discussed about this in the lesson. Imagine that your exercise is, imagine you are the little child. Write in your own diary. Write in your diary about what you saw. You could use these words. They have given you some sentences. In this you have to fill. Right? They have given you some sentences here. By using you can fill it. This is also your homework. Understand? So this is about today's class. In next class, we will see a poem. Gymnastic clock. The question answers, exercises, everything I will make PDF and I will put in your WhatsApp group. So I hope you understood today's class. If you have any doubts, please contact me. You have my number, right? Chalo then. Thank you.